Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, you will be introduced to the sine, cosine, and tangent ratios, which are the fundamental building blocks of trigonometry. The word trigonometry comes from a Greek word that means measuring triangles. You are going to see so many triangles in this unit that you'll start seeing triangles everywhere you go. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to find the sine, cosine, and tangent of any acute angle in a right triangle. Our agenda for today is to identify the hypotenuse and the opposite and adjacent sides of an acute angle in a right triangle. We will also define sine, cosine, and tangent ratios, and we will complete a practice problem. Let's start by identifying the hypotenuse of a given triangle. We have this symbol at a vertex of the triangle signifying that this is a right angle. The hypotenuse is always across from the right angle. How we label the adjacent and opposite sides of the triangle depend on which acute angle that we're working with. Let's start by using angle B as our reference angle. The opposite side to angle B is the side that's all the way across from it and doesn't touch the angle itself. The adjacent side is one of the sides that creates the angle. The other side used to create the angle, of course, was the hypotenuse. Now let's rewind and use angle A as our reference angle. The hypotenuse doesn't change, but now the opposite side has moved, and so has the adjacent side. We're going to identify our trig ratios for angle A first, so let's keep our sides labeled just like this for now. Sine, cosine, and tangent represent the ratios of the sides of a right triangle. Let's define these ratios for angle A. The sine of an angle is the opposite side over the hypotenuse. For angle A, the opposite side is 3, and the hypotenuse is 5, so the ratio is 3 over 5. Next, let's define the cosine ratio. Cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. So for angle A, we have an adjacent side of 4 and 5 for the hypotenuse. Tangent is defined as the ratio of the opposite side over the adjacent side. The opposite side to angle A is 3, and the adjacent side is 4. Let's try to do the exact same thing, but this time let's use angle B. Notice that the opposite and adjacent sides have switched places. The adjacent side touches angle B, the opposite side does not. Our goal is once again to find the sine, cosine, and tangent of angle B. Why don't you pause the video now and try this one on your own? Let's check our answers. The sine of an angle is the opposite side over the hypotenuse. For angle B, the opposite side is 4, and the hypotenuse is 5. Next, let's check the cosine ratio. Cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, so for angle B, we have an adjacent side of 3 and 5 hypotenuse. Tangent is the ratio of the opposite side over the adjacent side. The opposite side to angle B is 4, and the adjacent side is 3. Here are our general setups for sine, cosine, and tangent. Also notice this symbol. That's pronounced theta, and it just means an angle goes there. Anyways, now that we've learned how to find sine, cosine, and tangent, let me fill you in on a shortcut. You may really like this because it's a lot less to write. What you see here is the long way to write everything. The abbreviations look like this. Also, if we take the first letter of each word here, we get a fun way to help us memorize all of this. SOHCAHTOA. We will refer to SOHCAHTOA a lot because it's a great way to help us remember what sine, cosine, and tangent represent. Now let's complete a practice problem. Here's another right triangle. Using what we've learned, pause the video now and find the sine, cosine, and tangent of angle A. Let's check our answers. First, we correctly label our sides in relation to angle A. Then, we use SOHCAHTOA to help us remember that sine is opposite over hypotenuse, cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, and tangent is the opposite side over the adjacent side. Now we can find the sine, cosine, and tangent of any acute angle in a right triangle. Don't forget, SOHCAHTOA, and what each of those letters stand for. See you next time. Hey, hey.